If you guys actually got an ad in this video, don't take it too hardly. Let me explain at least. This is technically an update video, not necessarily a, super sad video and all that types of stuff. I want to not only go over what's actually, what the title says, but I also want to go over a few things I want to do a little bit differently with my channel, just a little bit. Nothing too much, just a little bit different, like my new upload schedule I would like to try and doing, and what I... and how I want to manage my streaming schedule, which will, again, be over to Twitch and not YouTube, because my Elgato capture card software, for whatever reason, doesn't want to actually work with my YouTube channel, and I'm not sure what is the case, but I, for whatever reason, cannot fix it, so, but I'll, go over that after I go over the elephant in the room, Anyways, no, your eyes are not tricking you, no, this isn't a clickbait, I am... for the most part, leaving the Splatoon Gmod / SFM community, the Splatoon animation community. And when I say mostly, I'm also kind of saying that I just want to de-associate myself with the majority of the people in the community. And when I say the majority, that means that there's only a handful of people that I am willing to, still talk to, willing to still hang out with, willing to still do things with, but that isn't really a lot of people, to be honest. And funny enough, the majority of these people who I still want to, talk to, who I still want to, hang around with, actually do play Splatoon 2. Well, at least, most of them, except for one of them, but I don't want to mention who. But just the biggest thing that I'm doing is just de-associating myself with, the quote-unquote big people of the community. For mostly, two reasons. Number one, I feel like you guys already know about this one, but kid touchers. I'm gonna call them kid touchers because, YouTube's demonetization bot really likes to hunt people who, use that word, the other word. So, the majority of the big people in the community are kid touchers, and at first I originally was only minorly upset about it, and I didn't really put too much thought into it, but it was until, the kid touchers in the Smash community were exposed and were pretty much canceled almost right off the gate. And then it made me realize that, hey, how come they're canceled right off the gate? Because they're smart and they know they shouldn't be hanging around in a community when they're technically criminals. But then in the Splatoon animation community, we're all fine with hecking, big YouTubers. Well, I want to say big YouTubers, but, somewhat decently sized big YouTubers still hang around in the community when two of them were exposed because of another community that, try to get them out of the gate. And at that point, it made me realize that, number two, this community isn't really safe for me. If we're going to have a community with, kid touchers still running around in the community, well, either number one, being really immature about that, which is my third reason, or number two, they aren't being canceled, then at that point, I just thought, you know what, this isn't really safe for me. I don't want to, have an internet presence around a community where these people are just like, they actually, they hecking, touched kids. Well, not to a physical level, but to an, online level, but the fact that they did it is still concerning for me. And again, third reason, immature, but, kind of to a certain extent. Most of these people in the Splatoon Gmod community kind of live around like as if they're just, they don't have any, they're just in this big bubble, They're in this big massive bubble, and when it gets popped, they, instead of, admitting to their faults, or trying to do something about why they allowed that bubble to get popped, or, do something about it, they instead reform that bubble, and then make everyone who, provoked the bubble, but try not to pop it, look like the bad guy, even if, it was with constructive criticism, or if it was them trying to warn them that what they were doing is literally morally wrong and illegal. But people with the bubbles, who are the majority of the immature people in the community, just don't seem to listen. And again, at that point, I kind of took it as a, I mean, it sucks, but it's not a big deal, right? But again, it was until the kid touchers in the Smash community actually did get exposed, and they actually got canceled, and then the people in the Splatoon animation community didn't, and that made me really upset that I was hanging around in a community where we're okay with letting technically criminals just run around doing whatever. And that, again, made me really upset, And I, at that point, just felt very unsafe hanging around in a community where we're allowing them to just still exist or allowing them to still making content and we're completely fine with it. And at that point, I was just angry that we're allowing it. And in the Smash community, we obviously did not because, yeah, the Smash community definitely is for sure a very toxic community, but at least they proved to me that they actually do have, you know, this thing called common sense, which I hate saying this, but the majority of the Splatoon Gmod / SFM community just clearly seemed to not have at all. And again, I felt very unsafe hanging around in a community where if you don't have that, then what the heck? So that's pretty much my reason why I've left the Splatoon Gmod / SFM community. And you know, if you've been kind of part of my YouTube channel for quite a while, you would have definitely known that this was inevitable one way or the other, that I was going to leave the community because, again, I just can't handle the idea of hanging around with people who just live in this bubble, and if it gets popped, oh, everyone's the bad guy, I'm the good guy, shut up. You know, I just don't like that. So, like I said, I don't want this to be a big deal or anything, me leaving the Splatoon Gmod / SFM community. I really hope you guys understand why, at least. But don't worry, guys. Just because I'm leaving the Splatoon Gmod / SFM community doesn't mean I'm not going to stop playing Splatoon. Doesn't mean I'm not going to stop doing Splatoon Gmod content. But admittedly, you're going to see that a lot more rarely now, as I'm pretty sure you guys already picked up those flags since I only posted, like, two Splatoon Gmod related videos in this year alone, and they were both really short compared to, you know, all my other years where I actually posted legitimately decently sized Splatoon Gmod content, and there were like 8 of those in a year or something, I don't know. But I'm also gonna try to strive for a mixed bag, which means that I don't want to make a Gmod video solely around Splatoon, and I kinda wanna make it around, like, you know, maybe something around Neptunia, or maybe something around Mario, or maybe something around Sonic, or maybe something around Bendy, or maybe something around anything that I also happen to like FNAF, you know? So, Splatoon Gmod, as in terms of content for me, is definitely not gonna be the end. But I definitely just want to make those, not only as rarely as I used to, but I want to make them without associating myself with the people who are quote-unquote big in the Splatoon Gmod and SFM community, because I don't know. Kid Touchers, you don't want to associate with those people, trust me. Also, because I don't want to associate with the majority in the Splatoon Gmod / SFM community, that doesn't mean that I'm not going to just straight up not talk to anyone in the community. There are a handful of people that I will talk to, but I will only show the two that I will be okay with. My big reason is because I felt like they weren't, you know, maybe they didn't have a huge impact in the community, but they did. They have something that I really strongly like. These are the two people that I would still like to hang out with, you know, just in general. The Electric Squid, mostly because I don't really see him as a big part of the Splatoon Gmod community, but in a way I sort of do, mostly because of the content that he does kind of post from time to time. So again, I don't see him too much as part of the community, but in case he still is, I still want to talk to him at least, because he hasn't really done anything, you know, illegal, at least, and he still hasn't done anything morally wrong, at least. He at least has some common sense, so that's why I still want to, you know, hang out with him and associate with him and whatever. Inkling Kayan, I haven't really seen him done really anything wrong, you know? Like, okay, obviously I don't know what he does in his own time, but Inkling Kayan, again, same thing I said with Electric Squid, hasn't really done anything morally wrong or illegal, you know? So, I don't really have a reason to just not want to talk to, or, you know, hang out with, or do whatever with Inkling Kayan. So, yeah. So, those are the two people that I'll only, you know, reveal of who I'll still associate with. Other people, I will not yet, or I at least will not want to. There definitely will be some people that, who seem really small and who you guys may not know that I may be friends with, that I still may associate myself with, but at the same time, I don't want to associate myself with them too much to the point that, you know, because they're still a part of the community, and they're still doing things in the community, and again, I just don't want to do a lot in the community. It's already enough that I want to leave, you know? So, I hope you guys got everything that I've wanted to say about the Splatoon Gmod community and why I want to leave and stuff. So, again, don't take it as hard as possible. Don't take it as harsh. Don't take it as, you know, somber. Don't be all upset about it. Because, again, I don't want this to be some sort of like, oh no, this is an end of something, you know? The Splatoon animation community is like some big old Jenga tower. And, you know, after PixSurprise's video, it finally got pushed over. And it was like, it's like this big old Jenga tower. And once it got pushed over, it took like 3 plus, or maybe 2 plus years for it to finally just completely crumble to the ground, you know? I don't want to associate myself with a community that's basically a, you know, completely broken Jenga tower, you know? So, I hope you guys understand that. Anyways, on to the more lighthearted stuff. Updates of my YouTube channel and updates about myself. So, with my YouTube content, I'm going to update it to, instead of uploading YouTube videos every morning from my time, 10 a.m., 9 a.m., 11 a.m., whatever, Mountain Standard Time, I'm going to actually move that to 2 p.m., Mountain Standard Time. Big reason is it's almost the middle of August, so more than likely we're going to have a lot of people going back to school, online school or, you know, in-person school, whatever, doesn't matter. You guys are going back to school. At least I hope the majority of you are going back to school. You guys should be going back to school, and I don't want to upload videos just in the middle of, or just in the morning when you guys have just started going to school. And plus, I'm very positive that the majority of my viewers are probably, you know, somewhere outside of where I live, somewhere outside of my time zone. So I'm trying to upload videos at a time where it seems likely that you guys would be out of school by then. But I also want to keep in mind of the people that are also in my state and who are also still taking school or college or, you know, whatever, doesn't matter. So just wanted to say that I'm just going to be uploading more videos during the afternoon than I am the morning, because, you know, you guys should be going back to school. You guys should still be getting your education and all that type of stuff. You guys should be, that's actually it. You guys should be getting your education compared to pretty much everyone in the, you know, the Splatoon Gmod / SFM community. And if you get your education, you're going to be big brain, and one day you'll be more big brain than the majority of the people that that I've heard about from, you know, commentary channels that have been talked about. Jake Paul. Okay, anyways, another one. I'm gonna do everything I can to upload a little more frequently, even though I'm actually going to be doing college by the 24th of August. And my reason is because I've been noticing that even during the summer, I've been doing a lot less live streaming. I've been doing a lot less YouTube uploading. I think part of that could just be because I've got really into a lot of Neptunia. So I'm going to try my best to upload just a little bit more throughout, you know, the rest of the time all the way through December. And hopefully I can still keep it up even through, you know, next year and stuff. And if I don't upload as much content as I said I want to, well then, I guess I failed. And the last update, I'm not sure how big this one is, but personally, I think this is kind of a big one. On the 29th of August, I'm going to be getting my wisdom teeth removed. If you guys don't know what wisdom teeth are, they're actually not the type of teeth that grow because you're getting older. They're the type of teeth that grow solely to hurt you. Wisdom teeth grow around the backer end of your teeth, both upper and bottom, and they are, they're kind of the spawn of Satan, in a way, to the human body. Wisdom teeth eventually grow by the time you're the age of 17, and they start becoming a problem by the time you're the age of 18, which, ha ha ha, that's my age. And if I don't do anything about my wisdom teeth, they can actually do an extreme amount of damage that can, it revolves around them pushing on your, you know, your backer teeth, and when they push on it, trust me, it's gonna lead to some problems. And when I say problems, permanent problems. So I'm gonna be getting some surgery on it, or, you know, I'm hopefully the, you know, the dentists, the doctors, the whatever will actually, you know, do something about it, and hopefully I won't, you know, die trying to, you know, get my wisdom teeth out. That's kind of the thing that I'm worried about the most, just kind of spreading, you know, just kind of letting you guys know in the hopes that, hey, maybe there are those one or two people like you guys that would, you know, want to kind of just, you know, give me a little bit of support, because admittedly, I am really scared to get my wisdom teeth removed, because this is if we're discluding the silver tooth incident I mentioned on my stream, this is technically my first surgery, and I have no trust in any of the doctors or the dentists whatsoever, so I am really hoping that my surgery goes well, and that the aftermath is the least thing I have to worry about, because the most I'm actually worried about is the process. Because the process, you know, is what I just, what I'm just not okay with. So yeah, that's just all I wanted to say. I hope you guys enjoyed this little update video, and again, wish me luck on my, you know, wisdom teeth removal. And again, please understand why I wanted to leave the Splatoon animation community. If you guys enjoy watching this video, give it a like, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. I hope you guys have a wonderful day. And if you guys are my age, definitely get those wisdom teeth removed as soon as possible before they actually start becoming a problem. I'll see you guys whatever you do next. Take care. God bless you guys. Hope you enjoyed that Neptunia gameplay that I recorded today, because, you know, Four Goddesses Online is actually really fun. You should definitely try it out if you have a PS4.